What is up, YouTube? Have you ever just wanted to use Visual Studio Code differently for different kind of app development? Whether it's web development, Java, C#, or something else? Or maybe you're a content creator like me, and you need to segment your code profiles based upon if it's YouTube, Twitch, or you're just coding for fun. Well, by the end of this video, I'm going to show you how you can create code profiles and launch Visual Studio Code. This will take both your user settings and any extensions that you may or may not need for each one. So if you're ready to learn how to use Visual Studio Code with different code profiles, let's hop into some code. So before we start messing around with certain extensions and looking for certain objects in your code profiles, let's show you what it does. So this is my Twitch profile. I use this Tuesday, Wednesdays, Thursdays when I'm writing on stream. When I hit enter here, what you'll see is Visual Studio Code has opened on my other screen, and a specific set of extensions have been installed, which is ESLint, Copilot, GitLens, Midnight Synth, and Prettier. And that's it. So just these five extensions. Those are kind of my default extensions. And behind the scenes, there is some user preferences. So if we open user settings and we look at the JSON, I have these sets of user settings. So I tell it the size of the font I want, which is 18, the tab size of 2, the zoom level of 2, and quick suggestions are true and parameters are true, just to give you an example. Now, if we close this out and we run this again, but instead of using this one, we use YouTube, which is what you see when I code for YouTube. What you'll see is a different set of results. So it's opened, and now we can look at it over here. You'll see that my extensions, I only have four now, which is GitLens, ESLint, Midnight Synth, and Prettier. So I removed Copilot because I don't want to use it. And if I go to user settings and go to my JSON here, you'll see that quick suggestions are turned off, parameter hints are turned off, hover is turned off, trigger characters are turned off. A lot of stuff is turned off so that you guys don't get distracted when I'm typing code in and I just have to remember what it is. So that's what we're going to be building. So let's talk about how this is done. So to begin with, you need to create a folder called code profiles, or whatever you want to call where you're going to store all of these different profiles. Then inside of that, you're going to create a folder for all the types of that you might need. So I have a coding one, which is when I'm not recording or not doing anything on Twitch. I have a Twitch one and a YouTube one. Now you notice the coding one is empty, and that's on purpose. So from that, you're going to create a new folder, and we'll call this new folder data. And then inside of that folder, we're going to create another new folder called user. Now this is where we're going to store our config from our JSON. So you have a couple of options here. Firstly, you can copy your code from Visual Studio Code in the JSON, which I'll show in a second, or you can manually type out what you want. So if you open Visual Studio Code like this and go to Preference, Open User Settings, which is what we recently looked at, and then you click this button in the top right-hand corner called Open Settings, that will give you all the settings that you may have enabled. And because I'm not using any of my code profiles, this is all you get for me. You can also find this settings.json here. It usually gives you a nice set of breadcrumbs for you to find it. So here is where mine is, which is C users James app data roaming code user settings.json. So I'm actually going to go and grab this file. So I've navigated to this C users James app data roaming code user, and here's that settings.json. So I'm going to copy this. We're going to drop it in that newly created directory that we created under C, code profiles, coding, data, user. Now, obviously, if you're using Mac or Linux, the idea is the same. You can make it in your home directory or wherever you think is best for you. Just create this in the same structure. It doesn't matter if it's Mac, Windows, Linux, or whatever. All of this part stays the same. It's just the directory structure that changes. Okay, so we have settings now. These have been added. So if I open this in, say, Notepad, you can see here we have this Midnight Synth, edit inline suggestion true, and work best startup none. So if we change this to false, that won't exist anymore, but at least I'll know that this is working. Now we need to do extensions. Now extensions obviously change based upon what you're doing with your code. Maybe you don't want to load them all at the same time. So first you need to go and find the actual extensions. Now on Windows, it's under C, users, your username, .vscode, and then extensions. So on macOS, it will probably be fairly similar. It should probably be the home directory and then .vscode. You just need to find out where that's coming from. Then you can copy these extensions as such and then drop it back in your code profile directory. So in here, and we're going to paste it right in the root, separate from this data. Now in this extensions right now, we have all these different things, ESLint, GitLens, Midnight Synth, Prettier, and Copilot. Well, when I'm coding on my own, I don't need ESLint and I definitely don't need Prettier because I don't care about those. So I'm gonna go delete those out. Now this is all set up. So now we're actually ready to test this. So go ahead and open your favorite terminal. I'm using Git Bash with the Windows terminal and go to CD, and then to the code profiles directory. Now you don't really have to do it in the code profiles directory, but it's just easier for a demonstration. Then all you need to do is type the word code and that will open Visual Studio Code. Then you just need to tell it user data directory and then the directory that we want. So we can pick one either coding, Twitch or YouTube. So we're going to do coding slash data. And then for the extensions directory, so dash dash extensions directory, we're going to do coding slash extensions and hit enter. Then at that point, Visual Studio Code should open, which it has. And now we can check to make sure this worked by going to our extensions and seeing only three are now launched. And again, if we go to user profile settings, so open user settings, and zoom in a bit so that you guys can see. If we go to the JSON here, these are the three that we had, and then the window zoom level is just increased because I clicked the button. So now we've tested it and it all works, we could create ourselves an alias. To do that, you can type the word alias, and then inside of that is where we get to create our aliases. So we can just say alias equals coding equals, and then we give it whatever we need. So you just open a set of single quotes, and then we can do code dash dash user data directory coding slash data dash dash extensions directory coding slash extensions. And then we should be able to hit enter. And now we have the alias. You can actually just use it by typing the word coding, hit enter, and boom, everything opens up. So every time you need to do something, you can just use that as your alias. So there you have it, a way to create Visual Studio Code profiles based upon what you need them to do. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to drop it a like, subscribe to the channel for more web development, Jamstack content, and building SaaSes. And until next time, see ya.